Doctor, what is GI? What is glycemic index? This is a question I often get asked. In this video, I shall be covering the following. What is glycemic index or GI? How is GI measured? What kinds of foods have GI value? And lastly, where to find GI information of common foods? This is part of a series of videos that I am doing on glycemic index related topics. Before I start, I just want to welcome everyone. Thank you for supporting my channel. If you're new here, I am Dr. Chan. I am a medical doctor from Singapore. My passion is in activating and helping people to unlock the tremendous power of healthy lifestyle and eating habits to combat diabetes, cardiovascular disease, and other lifestyle-related chronic diseases. Okay, let's jump straight into today's topic. Firstly, what is glycemic index? Glycemic index, or GI, is a value assigned to a carbohydrate-containing food based on how much that specific food raises blood glucose levels when tested in a laboratory compared to how much pure glucose raises blood glucose. Arbitrarily, glucose is given a GI value of 100, and foods are also arbitrarily grouped into three categories. Low GI category for foods with GI value between 1 to 55, medium GI category for foods with GI between 56 to 69, and high GI category for those with GI of 70 and higher. It is important to highlight that this method of classification, grouping foods into low, medium, high GI categories, is totally arbitrary. It is important to note that not all foods classified as low GI have the same impact on blood glucose. Because a food with a GI of 1 is classified as low GI, and a food with GI of 55 also qualifies to be classified and labeled as low GI. There are many important things to note when using glycemic index to guide food choices. I shall cover that in greater detail in another video that I am planning for this glycemic index video series. But for now, let's go to number 2. How is GI measured? A food item gets assigned a specific GI value only if that specific food item has been submitted to a laboratory for GI testing. There are different research methods for assigning a GI value to food, and there are also many laboratories doing GI testing and certification. That is why you might find differing GI value assigned to a particular food when you Google it. It depends on where the GI testing is done and which method is used, amongst other things. I shall not go into the details of how GI is usually measured in a laboratory. I shall put the relevant links to this as well as useful articles and websites related to GI in the description below if you're interested. Let's go to number 3. Where can you find GI values of different foods? There are many sources that you can find GI value information, the most common of which is on food labels in the supermarkets, but usually only on food labels of some packaged processed foods, but not on fresh produce. And there is a reason why you do not find GI values information on all carbohydrates containing food items in the supermarket, even though all carbohydrates containing food items can have a GI value if they were sent for testing in the laboratory. Because what typically happens is this. A food manufacturer or food company wants to find out the specific GI value of a specific food item that they produce on market. They would then send the food to a GI testing lab to get it measured. Then with the result, they would put the tested and certified GI value on the food label for marketing purposes. All this can cost quite a lot of money. So that is why you will only find GI value labels on certain food items in the supermarkets. Because not every food manufacturer or company wants to spend the money to send their food products for GI testing. Let's use rice for example. You will find that not all rice sold in the supermarkets have a GI value on its packaging. Although most people would be interested in the GI value of the specific rice that they are buying. Because only food items with a GI of 55 or below would qualify to be labeled as low GI, it is perfectly understandable that food companies would only consider spending the money to send the food items that they are marketing to the lab for testing and labeling only if the food items have GI values of 55 and below. Because no food companies would want to spend the money to send high GI food products to the laboratory for GI testing and labeling because it would not make good business sense to spend money to put a high GI label on their food packaging. You would also typically not find GI value labels on fruits and vegetables in the fresh produce aisles, even though all of them have a GI value if they had been sent for testing. So, other than on food labels, where else can you find GI value information of foods? As with almost everything, you can find GI values of specific food products on the internet if you search hard enough. And if you are able to filter through the search results for the most relevant and reliable information. So instead of Googling for GI information, I would recommend that you use the International Glycemic Index database website maintained by the University of Sydney in Australia. It has the largest, most updated database of almost every food product ever tested from all the different labs from around the world. Let me show you an example. Right, so go to the website and you key in whatever they're interested in. Let's say basmati rice. Here you'll find a listing of all the different laboratory results of all the different basmati rice ever tested for GI. So you can click into any one of them. Right, and then from there, you can see which is a food company that submitted it, which lab that it was done at, and information like this. Okay, let's try another one. Okay, let's try bread. You see, you have 318 results. They can see the range of the GI of bread can be from the 50-something to the 80-something. Okay, let's look for another one. Let's say sweet potato. You can see the results are different. Sweet potato boiled and sweet potato baked. Sweet potato fried. That's what you do. You go to the website of this database. I shall put the link of this website below in the description. Then you just look for the GI value to the listing that matches what you're looking for. Okay, that's all I shall cover in this video. The first part of a series of videos on various topics related to glycemic index. In my this series of GI related videos, I shall be covering topics such as how to use GI values of food to guide food choices, GI values of rice, common mistakes people make when using GI values of food, etc. You can click on the link in the description below to check. I shall be posting more GI related videos in the playlist in the coming weeks and months. So do look out for them if you're interested and subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so that you would be notified whenever I post new videos. I shall also be putting a link in the description to my blog where I list all the different web pages and websites with useful information related to the GI topics I covered in this video. I hope you have found this video useful. Thank you for watching. I am Dr. Chan. Let habits be thy medicine. Let's unlock the power of healthy lifestyle and dietary habits as medicine. One dose, one habit at a time.